tend to get burned. Ooh, thanks.
Okay. Let me, for battle. So, I'm wondering how XXS can actually get stuff in the offlane. I feel like he's going to struggle a good amount versus Warlock and Clock, unless he gets some help. But IG is a team which really likes to secure their safe lane very hard.
Oh, Ward is down again. Wait, can't Moon, does he? Does he?
It's the same Ward every time. He has to get it this time.
Yeah, it is. when you do exactly the same thing three games in a row, it has to... Something has to flag.
The book was like,
and it was good for for Team Odd. Fuck, planet Odd.
Planet Odd.
Because the Sentry Ward didn't go down on top of their obs. They got out with the Warlock to get it down. Unless Witch Doctor is now going to remove
they
all
pinged
vision.
It. And they did ping it, and that's I think that might be one of the similar wards they did. I saw a ping coming out. It may have been from Misery.
Wait for it.
Moon, just taunts.
Like, he's always got a little spring in his step.
I like the Centaur taunt anyway, so that's cool. I'm right with that one.
Bobrica.
Misery, walking up, try to contest that rune. He sees two people right away, backs off. Misery has the full-blown laning items. We've been seeing, like, boots a lot on Clockwork, but he's got Stout Shield, double regen. He is full zoning. So that makes me think that Warlock is going to sit top for Centaur, and it looks like that's going to be the approach that they're doing so that Moon can actually get experience. Mid lane, Boboka. He's got boots.
You think it's the snipe?
He wants to. Weehaz seems to be quite aware of it, though.
They see and him. They see he, him just, now. He just walked into the lane to show himself. Either that or he's trying to force one of the supports, like if he realized that there's two supports on both side lanes.
It's the timing for
this. Like someone needs to babysit this. And then he'll walk underneath the obs ward and. Actually, no, he's far enough away from it. They're going to rotate up towards the top lane. You've got the secondary ultimate from Witch Doctor, which is the paralyzing cask. So he can move over towards Moon. Burning's here as well. Didn't actually go for the Beatles at the first level. So Shadow Word will give more than enough life to the Centaur to survive.
He's super tanky. Like he's got Ring of Protection Stout Shield, so makes sense. Yeah, Misery, like we said, committing full to being that kind of zoner. But XXS already. You know, I was worried for him about getting experience if it was a full tri-lane committed. But since this approach is coming out from Planet Odd, he's actually going to be able to get a lot down here with this double range creep pushing in.
Burning is really trying to come in on the Warlock. They don't want Moon. Moon's presenting himself, but they don't want to ride that Centaur.
They just don't want him to get free experience up here, because Sox is actually sitting pretty far back and giving Moon majority of the experience.
Well, that's why Bobica. He's burnt so many voids on Soxa, and now this time he'll actually have to Shadow Word himself. No level 2 over on Q, so there's no extra damage to come from this. From this gank.
This is good though for Planet Odd. Getting a good amount of extra experience out, although they're doing like the trade-off. Void is getting experience for the Centaur getting experience. It's quite valuable here for a Centaur, because Centaur can get zoned quite heavily and he takes a long time to kind of catch up and be a relevant force in the game. Soxa gets a stack off. He wanted to ideally pull that one to the side, but Boboka was there to mess with it. Top rune to DD. This could be where we see the first action happen. Weeha walking toward it. Is he going to be able to get it first? He is.
Now, Bobrica has the Void available, and now you can start Spirit
OP's
Siphon.
There.
Weeha will not have the movement speed, and Bobrica plays the Fog of War beautifully. The Spirit Siphon will do the rest of the work, and OP takes first blood right in front of Roshan.
Good old rune bait.
Starts just looking for some revenge. Shadow Word, I need a couple more hits to make this work, however.
Should be okay. He's got a Tango he can eat as well, just in case, but I believe he's fine.
He hasn't done it yet. Hold, and he's okay.
Yeah.
So, Warlock now moves off the lane. He's only going to carry down for the Bounty Rune. Misery's been having a good time trying to sort out this faceless Void, but Void's still got 3.5 levels. Battery Assault's causing him problems. Time Walk up.
They don't really have kill. They have, like, no kill potential on the Void. Especially once he starts getting more levels up. He's acquiring more stick charges as well. He's on his way toward level 4, like you mentioned. Got the magic stick. He's good.
OP said we're very happy with this start. Kill on the Lina. The CS is actually quite even. Lina was always one of these heroes that packed one hell of a punch in the early game.
They're both high range heroes. Lina, of course, getting that, like, I mean, this was a long time ago, but she got the 670 range now. Well, the Death Prophet has 600, but they both have nukes. They both have outspam, so they can just pretty much push it into each other and not really too worry about getting overrun when they in the creep department.
Moon would love some more CS than what he's got. When XSS has more than him.
They have to be a bit careful, because they don't know what the skill build is still on the Witch Doctor. It's always possible that he gets Maledict points, and he does have one for the attempted threat. Putting pressure onto Moon. Here we go. Maledict onto Moon. They've got the Beetle on him as well. It's only level 1 Maledict, but the damage is starting to add up. It might be enough with the wraparound from the Night Stalker. He's starting to tick quite low, but Boca's trying to go in for the Void. He gets it on him.
Oh, the Maledict just wore off.
That was extremely close. If the Witch Doctor was level 3, perhaps the additional bounce of Cask could have actually brought him down, but they forced him to use the Salve, and that's fine. Now it's the first night time. Let's see what Boca's able to make of it.
And now his ability to actually be more useful. He's looking towards the mid lane.
Well, could it be in some, he could be in trouble.
Don't put the bottle on the courier. He can actually go for both right now. They're going to go for Weeha. Lightstrike Array is down. Stuns over on Boca. Weeha into the trees. OP. Crypt Swarm's available. Warlock with his TP in. Boca will just back off. So Moon has lost his extra friend.
Reaction forced.
Yeah. And then he just runs away. Boots on level 100 of the night. Doesn't take him long to reach top.
Yeah, and like you said, Moon now left a bit on his own. He's doing great on levels, as expected, since the Warlock is up there. He's almost level 5. Void doing slightly better in both the farm and the experience. I think that's also kind of be expected when it's, you know, versus a Clockwork. Clock can't really do the most to just zone a Void, because Void just sits there and trades right-clicks with him. Mm-hmm. Especially because on the Dire side as well, the lane equilibrium is a bit more in favor of the offlane.
This mid lane so passive thanks to the vision from both sides. Both have observer wards down. So Night Stalker doesn't catch him out, and Leader knows when she's not meant to go too far over. Faceless Void still doesn't have Chronosphere available.
Boca
running down into two supports while they're doing a pull shot.
Now he knows where they are though. So he gets the vision, and now he might actually try to make that rotation. Q.
They're running into the mid lane.
He had a ward on him. I'm thinking Weeha may have expect. I think Weeha might have thought that he warded there. Moon did, because he pinged it out.
Boca
kind of thinking something was happening.
Takes flight and Weeha runs away.
Misery? Gets the double damage and takes it from XXS. He actually cogged him in as XXS was clicking on it to take it. That was very well played. Mid lane, Weeha in some trouble here.
Yeah, that's silence, but where's your stun? The paralyzing cast from Q will arrive. Lina. There's only 2 kills for Invictus Gaming so far, and both of them belong
Misery.
To OP, and Misery just walked in! OP can keep up by just getting pushed by the cogs. The Spirit Siphon and Exism were gonna do the work.
I think he was just trying to walk up and actually just cog and push him back, but unfortunately gets caught, gets the Death Prophet caught inside with him, and I see this happen to Clockworks all the time. They really want to like defend their tower or something when they're low level, and just a small little misstep comes out and they do die. It's not like the biggest case of death. The thing is that you just get a bit underleveled is the biggest thing.
That's the damage onto the mid tower as well. The fact that you burned Exorcism, it was the time with the wave that had the catapult too.
5 minute push, yeah.
They actually have to deny the mid tower. The catapult's gonna hit it in just a second, and they know they can't kill it in time.
That was a great rotation coming out from them. It was kind of spotted by Weeha, but I don't think he expected the Witch Doctor to just sit there for so long. And the quick rotation from Boca.
So in 90 seconds, where does IG go next with OP? Your Chronosphere is up. Should it be a rotation to bottom? Do you start burning through these tier 1 towers?
I think they might bring Burning down there as well. I think they might go down, try to put the pressure on Reza with like the 2 supports, and then maybe even Burning comes down and goes to pressure that tower.
You're looking for a copy of game 1?
Yeah, the 4-man rotation. It's something similar to what a lot of these teams
Resolution.
Do. Resolution.
There's your first Void. You can leap into Chronosphere. Witch Doctor doesn't have level 6, however.
Yeah.
So you don't have the physical damage to get through the troll.
They're pushing him out of here, though. They're going to siege without Burning. They're going to leave him up there, and he's going to just do whatever he wants to do running around. He's just going to stay there and at least try to pressure Moon. Moon
Misery.
Is farming very well.
He can't get the cogs off on Boca. Boca's got too much movement speed.
So it was also still nighttime. Night's about to end right now, but he can just fly out when it is nighttime with that Hunter in the Night. How's Moon's gold? So he's got the Tranquil Iron Talon. He's level 6, so they do have Stampede online for disengaging if OP is... If OP finds any opportunities bottom lane. And it looks like OP is invis. He is looking for something. They have Stampede on planet odd.
He doesn't have a silence, however. Observer Ward was planted down. Exorcism is a little bit longer, and now they just started Spirit Siphon on both Misery as well as the Troll Warlord. Should be enough damage to kill off one. The Cog's pushing back OP. It's not a lot of mana to work with, but still enough for one more Spirit Siphon following Misery into the tree lines. One time lock from XXS, and that's exactly what doesn't happen. He still just gets the punch in. Yep. So two heroes lost.
Defensive Stampede being used, but it was... part of it was still inside of the Chronosphere, and also, well, the cast coming out from the Witch Doctor just keeps resolution in place. So nice rotation coming out from OP. I don't believe that they scouted him grab that Invisioned. They do have a River Ward, but it doesn't actually... I don't believe that one catches vision of the... Sorry, I'm just checking. Yeah, it does not catch vision of the rune positioning, so they had no idea that OP was coming in there.
This is just so clean from IG. 5-0 on the board. They're fighting middle, they went back, they shrine dump, now they're fighting bottom, they back up, they shrine up, but this one's even better because they didn't have to commit the exorcism of OP. So there's no way that Odd want to come into this fight. Like, you can rock it for a little bit of vision, okay, now they are going to.
Super dead.
Yeah. I'm not certain what Saxa wants to do apart from leech a little experience.
Misery trying to get on top of Q here, but he may have actually put himself into a deep too deep of a position. They're going to turn on him. OP's there. He has a Spirit Siphon as well. He's going
to
TP, though.
What a time to TP on the T1 tower, but yeah, he's got enough time.
He's good. But yeah, like you said, IG just making the right movements. Quick Dota in succession versus a Troll Warlord. That's what you want to be doing. We've talked about it, like... I think we're like beating it to death, but Troll Warlord, he takes time. He's not this like very early game centric hero that dominates.
I kind of want to say the same thing about the Lina for the moment, because she doesn't really have a great combination to ensure a kill, mm-hmm. and a lot of her targets are really, really tanky.
Yeah, they need Moon Meander pretty much. It's like, Moon, you need Blink for us to really take like good fights, and Warlock 6.
Yeah, but it's still Blink and to hit the Hope Stomp while keeping Vision.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wondering if they can even do that on Burning. Burning sees the Blink come forward. If he can hit Shukuchi in time, I suppose you just bring your Dust along, but...
Yeah, he's just going to build the Durable. That's the thing for the Weaver this game. Because the damage is coming out already from the Death Prophet. They have the control from the Void. They have Witch Doctor as well and Night Stalker. He just needs to survive through the instances of damage that Planet Odd dishes out. So we'll see him go for like Dragon Lance, maybe even Lincoln's right afterwards.
Okay, that's just a really nice stack.
Yeah, what is it? Four, maybe? Five?
It looks like four. It's,
one,
it's more
two,
now.
One, two, three, four, yeah. Five. One, two, three, four. Four?
Four.
Four. Five.
Satters. Oh, mid lane? Yeah, they're going up to OP. Stampede trigger. They couldn't get close enough.
Wow, that's actually... That's the two Stampedes used that weren't able to save anyone or actually get any kills there. So OP just being very aware of that movement coming in. Hugging the right side.
You did bait out the darkness, however.
Yeah.
So Nightstalker did burn that.
Not the biggest deal, though, because the next nighttime is coming up soon right after it ends.
Yep. And he actually finds Moon. Hi. Bye. Oh, no. Hi again.
Supports on the side of Planet Otter. Pretty underleveled. Saxo, I believe, did he just eat the tome? I want to say he did, because he just hit his level 6.
But you got level 4
level
on 4
Misery. Clockwork, yeah. I see this happen a lot on Clockworks, honestly. Like, when they're playing the support role, when you suffer a bit in your laning phase, because you're trying to just be this like full zoner, and then you try to like defend your mid tower, it's actually this exact move. You get a bit underleveled, and that just happens. It's not really like faulting up Misery too much. It's just, he ideally probably just wanted to pull a bit more.
Isn't that when you try and give him a space in the lane to play catch-up?
Which lane do they give it to, right? Like, yeah. Lina wants to park himself in the mid lane in Resolution.
Like the only lane is bottom, but getting caught out by Faces Void's Chrono probably means there's someone else behind him and you're dead.
IG's movements are just a bit too fast right now for them. They're not really, like, expecting these to come out. We see, like, the very deep wards coming out from IG. It seems like they're just, like, one step ahead of what Planet Odd has been doing so far.
Well, Planet Odd's going to try and force the issue. So, five heroes
they're setting
the top
up, though. IG's smoking. They're coming.
Stampede's up in 2 seconds time, so we'll be able to initiate, but look at the pings. Misery has moved over perfectly.
They saw
and
it.
The Cogs block him back. The Rock will connect on 4. So will the Fatal Bonds. They all have to get the hell out of here, but Paralyzing Cast making life difficult, but then again, maybe not the Chronosphere. It connects on 3, actually getting 4 as XSS caught burning in the middle of it, but they don't want to fight this. Without the Death Prophet, they don't have the damage output.
Beautiful ward coming out from Planet Odd being placed on top of the shrine. They saw them all gather there. They saw the smoke happen and Misery sets up on the high ground. Great rock Fatal Bonds by Soxa. Taking a look at the fight recap, you can just see how much damage he did with it. 2,132 damage from the extra AoE damage that they had. So
they're coming
good.
Though.
Very good read of movement and just great warding coming up from the supports.
Defensive cogs from Misery gonna actually not help him get out of there with a flying vision from Bobica. They saw over the cogs, he was able to avoid, cancel the TP. That's one down, so okay, you committed pretty heavily there.
Exorcism was used though. To defend when they went in for the for the fight, he did commit exorcism and he died. But now the big ultimates are expended from Planet Odd, so they're actually just gonna try to continue pressuring this tower. And they have a ward behind it too, so Planet Odd needs to be careful how far they step up. Boboka, he's eyeing Weeha.
He's just staying out of vision.
I think this tower is more than likely given up.
Yeah. But it's not the trade-off they were really hoping for. Okay, yeah, you definitely get two kills. One's on the big core, which is going to be the Death Prophet. But the push will still continue.
Yeah.
And you don't take any tier 1 towers of your own.
They ideally wanted to get that push going on that tower, but at least they have Resolution, who notices this is all happening. He ports bottom, pushes the lane out, and now he's beating on the tower. So they're at least getting a trade during this situation. And Moon Meander's also got his Blink Dagger when he's able to pick it up.
TP's actually going to bottom lane now.
Yep.
So it will be the face is Void to defend the tower.
Yeah, Void doesn't really help push the tower. It's Death Prophet and Weaver pretty much hitting it, so...
Well, Lina's gonna take the mid. Like, TP Void towards the bottom, sure. Top tower will finally fall. Hot clock. He got the denial. Misery.
There,
he'll sacrifice his life. Centaur can't do anything. I was gonna say, if you lost the clockwork, maybe that would be an okay trade-off.
Moon actually grabs his Blink Dagger, TP's top, but Boboka gets the silence on him instantly as he blinks in. So he wasn't actually able to get his hoof stomped for some type of turnaround. Weeha was in the vicinity to kind of come in there if there was a stun, so he could follow up, but great silence coming out from Boboka.
Real... I'm seeing more issues here now with the Yule Scepter on Death Prophet.
He's got it finished already.
Yeah.
And he's going to go for that Solar Crest build to deal with the Troll Warlord.
It's looking good for him.
Yeah, OP's...
Burning actually decided after Dragonlance to go into Diffusal Blade as well.
Okay, he's gonna do just the Diffusal Blade too, okay. I was wondering if he was gonna, like, go all out for, like, Lincolns and everything to deal with the Laguna, because they don't really have too much to proc the Lincolns, but having his type of damage, this is more of, like, the standard build that we do see, so he can actually kill people, because Diffusal gives you a lot of damage on Weaver. You get a crazy amount of agility, the double mana burn, and lets you just run people down with the Purge, of course. Just good item build.
Mid lane. Access is going to be the defender of OP. OP doesn't want to make this too obvious, however, so he's backing up from the creep wave.
They're setting up, though. Yeah, they're setting up that defense.
They really want Planet Odd to jump this. Yeah. They really, really wanted it. Odd did not take the bait. And right now, Invictus Gaming are looking better. They had a huge advantage to start with. Their experience is going their way. The gold is starting to go back their direction, too.
Yep.
But they have to keep the pressure up. The longer this goes on, the more items are going to start to arrive in for Planet Odd. I suppose you could say the same thing about Invictus Gaming. Their mid-game items are going to look really, really good with the start.
Yeah. Void, whenever he has Chronosphere, they can try to go for fights.
And speaking of Chronosphere, they go over on top of the Warlock, and, well, with Maledict, it's more than enough work.
That's a Chronosphere commit, though.
True, but no Exorcism and no Death Ward. Mm-hmm. So you've still got a nice zoning and okay.
Oh, he's got the Medallion, they're going into the Rush Pit. It's level 2 Exorcism online now too.
That's so quick, but they need to be quick. They got 12 second window before Warlock can get back here. Clockwork, Rocket flies in, so Misery. So they
a lot
get
of minus
the
armor.
And Burning, he's body blocking it, or is he? Runs forward, they go for the silence. Weeha came in to try and fight. Now Moon, the double hoof stomp and double edge. It's almost enough damage to kill off the Witch Doctor. Resolution will be able to put him in the grave. Speaking of the same thing, Weeha, the initial person that started off the fight, he'll go down a quick silence onto Moon. You've still got that Exorcism doing that physical damage that IG loves so much. XSS needs a time lock to catch out the Warlock. You will lose your night time now, but at the same time, Burning so quick. The Rock will fall. It's a three-man Fatal Bonds. Misery gonna try and split this fight up by putting down the cogs. It actually locks in Burning, so he can't keep the chase going. It'll time-lapse off a large portion of the damage.
Misery tried to get a hook on the side onto the Death Prophet, but he actually just misses it. It was just actually short. But they end up grabbing Weeha and Moon. Those are the big ones.
I'm not certain who you really feel has the real win out of this. Exorcism is burnt. You don't kill off Roshan. IG are waiting for the Shrine to come off cooldown, which is in 2 seconds' time, and they'll be ready to fight once more. But without Exorcism, without Chronosphere, Burning throws the Beatles out, so Resolution. They feel like they can do Roshan. He is fairly low. A double silence on Troll and Lina. They're trying to get rid of him, and they have done so. The Golem has fallen. They've lost their frontline tank. But with Resolution having Vladimir's, they may still feel there is enough. Where's that Death Ward? Hookshot forward. It's going to be on top of Misery. They're still inside the pit. Burning is waiting for it. There is enough for the Laguna Blade to bring down the Night Stalker. Who gets Roshan? Burning will snatch the Aegis Immortal. Resolution will fall on the Death Ward from Q. The damage output is nice. It just enables the rest of Invictus Gaming to do the damage. And Burning time lapses just in the nick of time. Chasing after Warlock. They are the time masters, Invictus Gaming, with the time walk forward to kill off Suxa.
That's without Death Prophet Ultimate, that's without Chronosphere. The cask actually there bounces between Roche and between Resolution like two times and then bounces to the Warlock or bounces to the Warlock and the Lina. So they just get kind of owned actually by that Witch Doctor. So this
Second ultimate.
Yep.
Feels like it every bloody time.
I have to restart really quickly. Here's my Dota actually crash.
Nice. Diffusal Blade now gets done by the Weaver, thanks to the money from this. Top tier 1 tower is an issue of concern, but it looks like the rest of Invictus Gaming, if you lose the tier 1 tower, Moon jumps out. So the tier 1 tower will take some kind of harassment, but they're grouping up. So they had the fight, they won it, and now all these abilities you talked about that were not there during the fight are coming back off cooldown. So you just push the bottom lane, OP's there. And Odd really need a really good fight.
Yeah, they do. And now it's Arcane Rune, Death Prophet Ultimate.
Really?
That's right at the end of it, so this is value.
She's just gonna TP towards the top lane and hold it if possible. Nope. Tower will go down nice and quickly. Maybe that's when you look towards the chip in a different area. But Boca is inching his way towards the north. I hope he's just having the time of his life. Exism will wear off now. But with the momentum coming down the mid lane, Invictus Gaming don't need the Exorcism to take out the tier 2 tower.
They know Rock's still down. It should be up pretty soon though, so they do have to be a little bit careful of how much they overextend. That was a bit of their downfall in some of their previous games. And they will back off accordingly. Back to farming. They do have Chronosphere online, and Death Prophet Ultimate is not really that long. I believe it's what? It's like 40 seconds up until it's back up or so?
41. Yeah. Yeah, they run forward. Resolution. Diffusal Blade's gonna stop this. And the Rock and a four-man Fatal Bonds once more. Yulset will buy Death Prophet a little bit of space. She wants to run out this one. Misery in very, very deep. The damage output. They are gonna bring down OP. Misery wants to sacrifice his life. No! Wait, did he just get denied? I thought for a moment he did, but no. Something else got denied in the middle of it all. That's Q who gets the kill into Misery.
Rock committal, they didn't have XXS there. He was actually top, looking like he wanted to set up something whenever Moon showed, because I think Moon showed for like a short minute and he was sitting there waiting for some type of setup. But I think that was a little bit over aggressive by IG there. You know, they only had like 20 seconds or so for the Death Prophet ultimate to come up, but it was also just a good bait coming out from Resolution. Rezo runs in, they're like, oh, we can kill this guy, and then beautiful Rock comes out, four-man Fatal Bonds.
It's amazing how long it takes him to kill off Misery as well.
I mean, Clockwork, dude. Clock's a super tanky hero. Look at him. 1400 HP with, like, zero health items. His strength gain is absurd. 3.2 per level.
And once he picks up the Blade Mail, it's going to be a lot more difficult for Invictus Gaming to say, hey, let's just pop this guy.
Yeah.
But then again, the longer this game is going on, the stronger Burning is also becoming. Yeah. He's the top net worth on the field, and he's able just to find space in every single engagement because the initiation from Moon is still lackluster.
Yeah, and it's also like when you're playing versus a Death Prophet, it's like all eyes on Death Prophet, right? You're like, you need to kill this hero inside the fight, and that gives Burning a lot of like room just to weave in and out of the back lines. And the also the reason that I was saying that they probably didn't really entirely want to take a whole fight there was because OP was sitting on like 2400 gold, and if you look, that's their whole advantage in this game right now. And now he has it picked up though. Finishes up the Solar Crest, so his tank ability is way higher.
Yeah. It'll be a lot more difficult for them. Fortification will be burned. Understandable when Exorcism is ripping into your tower. But Invictus Gaming, you want to go further than this. Exorcism is not going to last that long with the Fortification already being burned. They may get a little bit of chip time into the Tier 3 tower, but the trade-off is Resolution pushing the top lane, and that's why Faceless Void TP's up, tries to hold himself inside the Fog of War, but it's already too late. Misery and Resolution will both back out. And the Aegis Immortal will time out in 32 seconds as well.
Yep, still good, pretty good Aegis usage. They got a couple towers and stuff, so.
Yep.
I mean, denying the Aegis is also super important. Like, that was just a great steal coming out from Burning.
We'll have to slow down the engagements for a little bit, though. We are going to hit daytime once more, and it's still only a level 1 darkness. Here comes the rest of Odd. They know daytime is arriving.
Yeah, they're trying to set something up.
But it's 35 seconds until daytime. This smoke won't last that long.
Exorcism is still on cooldown, though, and burning the Aegis. This is one of those like Aegis smokes. As soon as the Aegis is timing out, you try to find an opportunity on it whenever someone shows. But IG is like, dude, something's up. We got four wards around the mid lane. No one's farming the jungle. No one's mid.
They smoke themselves.
Something's happening. And yeah, here we go.
Hunter of the Night's on cooldown for 8 seconds. They have scan? 10 seconds until daytime.
The scan catches them. Planet Odd scan does see that IG is up to something, and that was right on top of their ward, so they know that IG smoked right now.
They're going around. Burning only knew there's a double damage rune inside the river. They're going to trigger darkness and come from behind. But look at the position of Misery. It's so good. But do they actually see him? Yeah, they do.
They do.
They have perfect eyes on Misery. So darkness now triggers. Where's your silence? It is there. So Misery won't do anything. It's a perfect chronosphere. It's the Warlock and the Lina. The two big controllers. Warlock has already been deleted. And the Cogs, it splits the fight up quite nicely. Weehars, there is stun. There is. There's the Yule Scepter catching the Lina. She'll have to deny herself with the Bloodstone. Two heroes down. Now down to 8 charges for the Lina.
That was good. Very good read coming out from IG. They put a circle in the location where they're like, they might be here, and they make the run. They try to go all the way around. Good scan coming up from Planet Odd, but just a great wraparound coming out from IG. Those are those like really nice heads-up plays that teams at the high level actually are able to notice. There's no one farming on like any of the wards. No one showing in a couple of the lanes. You just get a lot of information from this. So, again, both teams with very nice warding coming out this game.
Invictus Gaming are the ones who are still getting the upper hand. 3k in the gold, about 1.7, maybe in the experience.
Still is very close.
Yeah.
It is. It's 5 to 16, but Planet Odd is definitely keeping up in the farming level.
I like this build coming in from the Faceless Void. Understanding that Chronosphere is kind of dictating the course of most of these fights, he's actually going to go for the Aghanim Scepter on this Faceless Void.
I think this is, in my opinion, it's one of my favorite builds for the offlane Void. You're not the damage in this, you're the control. And every time your Chrono is up is when you can really take the big fight. So if it's up every 60 seconds, it's extremely beneficial for your team. Moon was building for it the last game. He didn't get to that point, of course, but he was trying to get it as well.
Oh, that tier 2 tower push, Resolution just rips it apart. And no one is coming to defend it. While Chrono is down, Invictus Gaming will not come out and play. That's why XSS is just currently farming up the Radiant Ancient stack, which was there.
Oh, he actually goes for the cast range talent instead of the 1.5 Cryptorm. I've seen players do both. They're both. It's very strong either way. You get the extra Yule's cast range, extra Silence cast range, extra everything. Like, it's just very useful.
Maybe this, well, I'd say, is it a non-Octarine game at the start, so he can't really benefit from it at the moment. Because he's going to go into the BKB instead.
Mm-hmm. He needs it this game. So much magical burst coming out from the Lina and the Centaur that's pretty much his saving grace, because he already has the Solar Crest to deal with the Troll Warlord.
Misery's waiting for the fight.
Oh, there.
OP's going to be the one to come forward. Q has moved off just a little bit too far. So OP, it is a three-man brute squad ready to jump him, and that's very, very uncertain.
They saw the Void with the ward, but they didn't see anybody else on the side of IG. So Odd was playing with the one information that they had. They're like, okay, Void is showing in one place, but the other three could be sitting right behind him, and we can get turned very easily.
So what looks like a great opportunity to us, they still didn't have all the information to work with.
Yep.
Alright, now group up once more. Looking for that smoke on any of the supports. It actually does not exist. So it's more just to sit behind your team, wait for Roshan. He is up in 2 minutes' time.
Q has his first item of the game. He's got his 4-step finish, so he can get his buddy out of the cogs now. It's actually a super important pickup this game. And now, did you see Baboka's item? Wow, I didn't even see him building up toward this, but he's got a full Atos. So we said that catch is a little bit of their problem here, IG. They really rely on the Void catching good Chronos, but Atos solves a lot of that problem. Makes him a lot tankier, which is very good versus the Troll Warlord, not even just for catch, but just if you grab him in Atos, you can just big R, ignore this guy, let's go for everybody else.
Yeah. Play around him, do what they did last time.
Yeah.
And what a great Chronosphere as well from that top fight. Like,
yeah, you got the perfect targets.
Yeah, Warlock and Lina. Shit, you couldn't have asked for something better.
Yeah. I think getting the Warlock is just, it's clearly the most important. It was actually kind of lucky that, you know, Weeha had, like, Bloodstone finished up there, so he could just get the suicide, because it could have been quite a big gain for IG, but as the game progresses, IG is actually pulling a little bit more ahead. They're getting a little bit more efficiency with their movements and farming a little bit better.
Well, they're always going to be ahead in towns as well.
Yeah.
Like, right now, they're very goldy out of towers.
Top lane, Rezo!
Have they actually got it? With
Burning walked into the chrono!
Okay, issues. Burning can't do the damage towards the troll warlord when you're locked in time.
Oops. I think he got the Whirling Axes off before the chrono happened too, so a lot of their damage is negated, and it's a 27 armor troll, and it's only two of you kind of beating on him. It would have been pretty hard to bring him down anyway, in my opinion, but
what a time to lose your chrono. Like, you committed your chrono when Roshan could be coming up.
Yeah.
You now don't have that huge team fight, and Misery's waiting for it. Roshan's almost at max spawn time, and you just got a fresh BKB onto resolution.
Oh, you're so lucky. You have a timer. Mine disappeared when I disconnected.
Can watch my screen. Watch I'm literally screen. Sitting next to you.
Unfortunately.
And they're already triggering the shrine. It's... I get worried about that kind of stuff before a fight's going to begin.
They want to be healthy, though, for the fight, since they don't have Chronosphere.
They're pretty up there. They just didn't have the mana.
Yeah.
The mana is what they were missing. So Roshan is alive.
This is really hard for them to fight without Chrono.
Yeah.
They have to pretty much catch Soxa, but Soxa is...
What do? You put Witch Doctor, like, right here and just put a Death Ward in the middle? Like, come and find me, boys.
I don't know if... I don't really think that they should take this fight without Chronosphere. It's way too risky. It's like they have no eyes on the Warlock whatsoever, and they need to catch him in order to take the fight.
Yeah, they're letting it go. Yeah. Willingly or not, here comes the bots. And Bovica, well, he'll run a Vatos over on the Centaur. Roshan killed by the Radiant, Aegis Immortal. It is picked up by Resolution. OP committed the ultimate. They want to go in for this, but there's no stun.
Odd can just disengage.
Yep, that's exactly what they've done. Stampede is down, but a big ultimate. That's the second one being blown by IG in the space of a minute, which achieves nothing.
Problematic for sure. They're still at a little bit of advantage for gold, but that was the second Rosh. So they've got Aegis and Cheese now for Planet Odd.
They got a 2-minute window with that Exorcism.
Yeah.
And Chrono's down for 13 seconds. Sure, they'll come up. But we haven't really seen Burning being able to reach in far enough into the Chronosphere to do enough damage.
Yeah.
It's always been the Exorcism of the Death Prophet. And they're trying to build her up higher. She's actually looking to build a heart next. Full-on tank for the Death Prophet.
Yeah, they need her to be extremely survivable. This is a huge timing window right now for Planet Odd. They've got some really good late game as well with their lineup. Well, I feel like IG's on a bit of a more of a timing. The nice thing is, though, that they're going to have the... when the Aghanims comes online for the Void, it makes the game look a little bit weirder because they do have, like, a single-core Weaver with a Death Prophet. While you look at Planet Odd, they have Lina, they have Troll. These two heroes scale a little bit harder than their counterparts right now in this game. Mm-hmm. But throw in a 60-second cooldown Chronosphere, and it kind of changes it up a bit. It's all depending on the initiation and who he catches.
Well, here comes initiation. Burning is not there. He's on the bottom lane. Potentially going to force some level of trade. That's if they can hold him out. Paralyzing cast being committed, so is Crypt Swarm. They're trying to make life difficult for Resolution. The harder they make it for Resolution, the harder it is for Weeha to also just sit there. And you're already having the clockwork TP down to the bottom lane. So Burning, trying to force the trade off. Misery has to hit almost a blind hookshot, which is impossible with a new creep wave arriving with Burning.
Stampede disengage. Burning gets... there's a pretty good trade. Gets a little bit more damage on the tier 3 than they actually did.
Misery's line is bottom lane. Please push this.
Yeah, he's get this out, and then we can make actual plays with our Aegis and Cheese. When they've got that lane pushed out again, they can actually go for another smoke. But do they have any more smokes online?
That's a very good question. We can't check that.
We don't know.
That was removed.
That was removed. But none of them are carrying one, so we will assume that they don't have one for now.
That's when they tried to fix, in commas, air. The shop was lost to spectators.
So in that last engagement as well, or don't really call it an engagement, but that last like Roshan kind of engagement thing, Boboka actually picked up a gem for himself, so they're trying to get a bit more of a map control advantage coming out, which I think is pretty necessary as well. Because whenever you see like this happening, like, I just claimed a bunch of towers. I've mentioned it like several times before, and several casters do. It's, you always want to claim an objective, get vision down on it, so you get more map control.
Resolution's coming up the bottom lane. He claims the objective of the tier 2 tower. Invictus Gaming are in position to defend. XSS is the one who's got involved. Still looking for that extra 210 gold. Once he has that, He has himself his Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah, he's very close. Troll Warlord going for the MKB next to deal with that Solar Crest and to deal with, I mean, if his BKB's on cooldown, the Crippling Fear can be pretty obnoxious, the 50% mischance.
Well, there's your Aghanim Scepter. He wants to solve something for it. I think it was it. Wait, did he have a Quelling?
He still has one.
I mean, yeah, you're
he
right.
He was close.
Okay.
I don't know if he had it, but did he sell Poor Man's Shield?
He was 200 point. Away, so he must have sold something like that.
Either way. He had a stick too at one point. He had Poor Man's Shield and stick, so he must have sold one of them for that. Well, level 16, Aghanims, he's got Blink. He's got pretty much all the tools that he really needs in this game. Unless he wants to become a scaling core, which will start happening after this. We'll probably see the command to Diffusal if it ever gets to that point.
I think they just pinged his Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah, they scouted him with the rocket.
That ping came the second the Clockwork Rocket connected. Like, quick, check items. Yep, he's got this. It's not a lot to save you from that. Even like things like Lotus Orb, Centaur, War Runner. I don't even know what that's meant to, like, dispels the silence from a Night Stalker would be the best thing.
Time dilation.
Yeah.
Dilation is the big one. It can reflect Cask as well, which can be huge. It can reflect Spirit Siphon, which is also pretty big.
It's a very good pickup this game versus what IG does have.
So very tense moment from either side. You know what IG want? They want a huge Giants team fight.
They're waiting for this Aegis to time out before they even want to do anything. It's gone in about 5 or 10 seconds.
I still hate the fact that doesn't exist. So that Aegis that just timed out, like when you hit the menu, like the freaking items, it doesn't appear as an actual item.
Yeah.
Please, please, please. Bother. Right, so Invictus Gaming, Aegis is gone. Darkness gets triggered and, Odd become very nearsighted.
They need to get out as soon as darkness gets out. They gotta get out. They've completely like shut down the advantage that IG did have though. It's 500 gold now in the favor of IG, which is negligible.
That rocket caught a glimpse of Burning heading down south, but the Vault has got home. Everyone is left.
I mean, look at that damage dealt really quick.
Why is it so high up on the clock where everyone else?
It's the rockets. It's actually just the rocket spam ends up starting to add up, but... I mean, just take a look at that, guys. There you go. Some nice production. Thank you for production.
Okay, we can get rid of it now.
Oh, they have to absorb everything. Come on, Toby.
Ah. There you go. Have this graph instead.
Oh.
Weehaw's actually about to hit his level 20 talent.
I have more fun ones. What else is there?
You do have power for this stuff.
I have the
power
right now.
You could be running poles as well, but no.
I don't know how to use that. I don't want to mess with anything. The only pole I see here is will OD Pixel miss first blood? And
you need the one of all the wards being purchased, because that's something which we cannot see.
That was actually a big one, too, this game. So we'll actually take a look at that really quickly. So wards purchased so far has been, as expected, the Warlock and the Witch Doctor. It's been very good vision coming out from both games, and it's had a very heavy impact on this game.
You see the difference in it, though. 73 wards to the 43 of Invictus Gaming. Like, that's still a heavy difference in the amount of wards purchased.
A lot more sentries, right, to deal with the Weaver as well as just dewarding when you're playing versus Nightstalker. You're at a limit. You're at a disadvantage playing versus Nightstalker versus Darkness anyway, so that's kind of to be a little bit expected.
Yeah, especially with that gem timing he got.
Yeah, and when you're... Planet Odd is playing at a bit of a disadvantage a lot of the game, so the way you come back when you're at a disadvantage is just having better vision than the opposing team.
Well, here comes Invictus Gaming. Four-man smoke up. They are missing the Weaver. The Weaver has his own form of transportation through invisibility. And they'll go right into the middle of Odd. Moon, there's the silence. They actually get both silence plus the Rod of Atos, but... Centaur Warrunner, freed by his own Lotus Orb, they move forward towards the Warlock. A quick stampede, movement speed is good, but your Scepter sends the Warlock up and towards the air. They still don't have the damage to kill him off. Weehaw, there's a stun! He'll actually cancel his TP out, so Weehaw isolated in the trees. Exactly the fight that Invictus Gaming wanted to take. One big ultimate committed. Chronosphere remains up.
Wasn't it that was the same place as the last fight? And the same two heroes died, but they didn't have to expend Chrono. Yeah. But they did have to use Exorcism, as you pointed out.
It's kind of stupid, though, that we said that as a positive thing when you got the Aghanim Scepter now on a Faceless Void.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, we didn't use Chrono, that's all! We had a 60-second cooldown timer. Okay, he should have just used Chrono.
He didn't have the opportunity to get any other heroes, so...
Mm-hmm.
Maybe using it on the Lina there could have actually been a bit beneficial, so he can't get the Suicide off.
Oh, OP.
But...
Look at him coming.
He probably wanted to hold it for better opportunities.
The Dire Observer, what if OP sees this?
Dude, the wards this game have been... extremely impactful. This division game. That's kind of what. That kind of happens a lot of the times when you're playing like with this like Night Stalker Clockwork.
Oh wait, do these bugs actually these connect? Things. They don't travel that far, do they? No, they don't. No, Mook can see him coming. He tried to force off himself out of the line of it, just in case they would travel that far.
He's got 15 seconds stuck on his TP cooldown.
Oh, Bobica takes the trees. Comes up. Oh, he sees him. He sees him. Oh, Moon in the trees. Where is your friends?
He knows the TP's on cooldown.
Burning's coming. Burning is coming. TP 2 seconds. Does he just try it? Here comes the bugs. Night Stalker's so low. Centaur may actually find the kill. In fact, he will do so. Four Star starts to TP. Here they come. The paralyzing cask will connect. Moon will fall. And the Gem of True side of Night Stalker gets regathered into the hands of the Witch Doctor.
He gets the trade, though. Trade kill.
Yeah. Resolution's getting time to farm. Lina's getting time to farm. They're adding pressure towards the top lane. Someone better come back here. And if they don't, in fact, OP, hot shot! Misery finds the target, pushing him back with the cogs. Laguna Blade, will it be enough? A quick yule set for the BKB trying to protect him. The rock will fall as well. Damn, they're committing hard. And that could be top lane. You'll have 72 seconds. Buyback is available for the Death Prophet.
There's no Centaur, though.
Yeah. Without him, but you got Resolution and you've got a Golem on the front line. So you've got the front line tank that's not as scary. Burning. A fully completed Skadi.
He's had that one for a bit.
Yeah, he has. Tricky, he's still looking for the Monkey King bar.
Yeah.
But it makes it impossible to run away if you get overcommitted.
Yeah. He's the, like we were talking about, like the susceptibility of the Weaver is getting bursted down, so he just wants to build just as tanky as possible. Same build that I think we saw Resolution do earlier.
It's like, just give him a Medallion buff up and he'll be fine. Let him sit in the front lines. That's a nice little rune to find, an Arcane. Weehar, I assume, will want to bottle that one up quickly. I'll say bottle, just take it.
Yeah, no more bottle.
Yeah.
Do they know this is up? They throw the scan on the shrine. IG is smoked up. The scan, is it going to get them? It does catch them right at the end there. So they know they're coming.
Halfway through Roshan, Misery will try and come in. The cogs will create space. The bugs from Burning sees inside the pit. And that's exactly where the Chronosphere is. But the hookshot, it's cancelling Burning from attacking into Resolution. That's the win right there. While Moon kept the rest of IG occupied. Paralyzing cask and bounce blitz on the two heroes protected by BKB. And that BKB lasts forever. Finally, he'll hit someone who's not with the Hulkstomp. Moon, he doesn't realize he actually connected onto the Weaver. It was better than he thought, but yeah, Death Prophet's back into the fight. Exorcism is up, and they're looking to really engage. You put the Diffusal into Resolution. The Cox creates space, but OP's BKB allows him to stand his ground, killing off Moon. The Yorceptor onto the Troll Warlord. They want Resolution down. Maybe with Upheaval, they can slow them up enough and get up towards the Shrine space where they can fight. But the longer this fight goes on, the sooner that Chronosphere is going to be back. 15 seconds till it's up. Lina will trigger off the cheat, so she's got the life, the negative armor gonna go into the clockwork as well as the warlock. They really want to find this kill onto Weehar, and they're able to do so. So back into the fight, Chronosphere 3-2-1 and Blink Dagger in 2-1. Let the jump go forward, and he can actually catch the warlock as well. No, he's holding on to it. Now he can catch both of them. The time walk up, finding the warlock. You'll take what you can get. Roshan is still alive for the moment, even though you don't have exorcism. But you have Burning. It may just be enough that they can try and take Roshan now.
He's so tanky on this Weaver. But Boko also eats the Laguna Blade, so for the team, runs in, dies for it, but very good plays coming out from IG. They just wanted to force the situation to kind of happen where both Weeha and Resolution pop their BKBs, and then with Death
Misery! He's gone in! And the Agassi model is snatched by Burning!
He doesn't get it.
Misery still got the kill onto Roshan. Who got the cheese? It wasn't Misery, was it?
No, he didn't get it. XXS ended up grabbing it in time. That was close. That was super close.
YOLO Misery. The fact he still survived, however, he went into the middle of four heroes and managed to get out while stealing the kill on Roshan.
Yep.
You'll still get props for that.
Did you see this?
See what?
OP, so he didn't have a bottle. He just purchased up a bottle, late game bottle. We've hit the 40-minute mark. Double runes are coming out. There's an arcane rune. He buys a bottle specifically just for this. I haven't seen players do this, but we've heard this talked about. As soon as this double rune change was added, I've heard a lot of players discussing, like, is it worth getting a bottle late game? And I do believe so it is. These DD runes, these arcane runes, they can be absolutely game-changing. He's got Octarine finished on top of it, so arcane rune, Octarine. Uh-oh.
Yep. Uh-oh, indeed. It's already 108 seconds on the cooldown for the Exorcism, which is coming off cooldown in 11 seconds' time, but it's the damage output from the Crypt Swarm. It's a shame he doesn't have the 10% cooldown reduction talent as well.
The movement speed's just way too good. 50 movement speed over 10% cooldown is just very little.
Through upheaval as well. So he's triggered the arcane rune, puts the bottle into the backpack, and then here comes your attack. So Exorcism back off cooldown, 76 seconds time. Can they survive this Laguna Blade OP? He has the cheese and the Chronosphere. Troll Wall launch called the Hawkshot Misery. Has to create space with a Blade Mail Cogs. He does exactly that, locking in OP as well as burning right in front of the tier 3 tower, allowing Resolution to beat it to the Death Prophet no longer anymore, thanks to the Yule Scepter. But Moon! The four-man hit! Do they have the control? Weaver can't get out! The Egg is immortal. It'll be burned up. OP still fighting that Exorcism. It lasts for so damn long. Maybe a good time to disengage as it is going to run out. But in 40 seconds time, they can go again, and 32 seconds till Chronosphere. Q's actually going all the way home, and Clockwork?
I think he died to Maledict.
It had to have been Maledict. It's the only thing that can kill you back at base.
Yep. Lots of damage being taken. He had to make the space for Resolution, because Rezo was grabbed inside that Chrono. He was very susceptible. Another Arcane Rune spawns bottom. Are you kidding me? He's just going to get another Arcane Rune. He just used Exorcism. It's up in 15 seconds. New Arcane Rune. Let's go.
Bottle value, man. Bottle value.
That was a sick stun by Moon there.
Yeah.
That could have been a very different fight if he wasn't able to get a four-man clutch stun.
The more of these stuns, the more they stay up. Like, you look at the item he's building into. He's 1,000 gold away from having an Aghanim Scepter. This is better disengage. Maybe not the greatest in the world to try and get out of the Chronosphere, but at least survive the Chronosphere with the damage reduction.
They're going for a play again right away. They see Resolution. They're going to go for it right away.
It's going to hold. He pulled him all in! OP, he can follow up with the silence, but for now, it's all about the damage. The four-man silence is there. The double BKBs will be triggered burning. He's going to try and focus on the Resolution while the backline's taken care of by Bavoka. Tashka, he's trying to TP himself out. It won't be successful. They look for more. Really, is Warlock the only one that's going to die from a four-man Chronosphere?
Oh my god. BKB TP by Rezo. He lives with like 93 HP he TPs out at. They literally all jumped on him too, but Boca like starts running in to try beating on him. XSS as well. Oh my god. How does only one person die from that?
Just the BKB disengage. But you know what? That was another Arcane Rune with the Exorcism, so it's going to be back up in 30 seconds. Chronosphere is going to be back online as well. And now the BKBs are starting to tick lower and lower and lower. I think it's down to 7 seconds up on Resolution, and Weehaw's is probably as well also 7. Down to 8, actually, so.
Yep. Chronosphere's up in 6 seconds. Exorcism in 22. and wait for it. 10 seconds. Look, OP, just sit yourself in the mid-river. In fact, he's already guessing.
There's going to be another Arcane Bottom. There's been 2 down here.
Okay. Drum roll.
Hey, that's pretty good, too.
Hey, Stream's fine. There's a regeneration rune. There's a regeneration rune up on top, so hey, you can't get arcane every time. But they should be ready to fight in just a bit.
That was just funny. That was like the most anti-hype thing ever. We're forming Chrono and nothing happens. Like one person dies.
Well, it was funny because they split the fight up so much. Like, I almost want to give more props to Bobica. Like, he has been really, really good today. And in just this series, been really, really good. Understood he had to shut down the Warlock.
Yeah.
You do it with the Clockwork previously. This time around with the Night Stalker, he's like, okay, you want a four-man Chrono? I'm going to just jump away from everything that's happening here and go in deeper. And Q went with him. He didn't just like say, okay, well, let's just throw down my Death Ward, which is level 3. Yeah, I can do so much little damage. But until that Aghanim's up, I don't think he really is that intimidating with the Chrono. But
Burning's starting to get more damage, though. You know, he had the MKB for the last fight. He's got another 3,000 gold on him. We'll see Void. Looks like he's going to be queuing up a BKB. Just wants to have that survivability so he can always get that Chrono off, since it's so crucial to their fights.
I'm wondering if it's actually worthwhile picking up something like a Bloodthorn. Now the BKBs are dropping down so low. Still gives you your crit. Or do you get something else on the Weaver? It could be a real pain in the ass and get an Aghanim Scepter and start time-lapsing OP, too.
Bloodthorn could be an option. I think maybe some like AC isn't so bad either. I think he needs damage though, so I think Bloodthorn could actually be pretty good. Especially versus like Troll. He already has the MKB, but helps his team as well.
I was thinking, what else could allow him to get a solo kill? Someone like a Warlock who has no escape. Like, we're gonna hand a Midas on this Warlock, still trying to desperately build into a mech he's now looking at. Like, the casual Buckler's at least giving something to his team.
He needs some armor.
He needs something. That's what he needs.
Troll's got no buyback right now. He bought up the MKB. So if he does get brought down, and
no one actually has buyback. They're willingly going into this fight with all five heroes from Odd not having a buyback.
Yeah, they've got, yeah, like you said, the Aghanim's finished up as well for the Centaur.
Yep. But they know. They know they have to win these fights. If they don't, it's just going to keep coming and pounding them down.
Are they going to bait this Arcane Rune?
Ooh.
They're sitting on it.
OP's coming. OP's coming. He's waiting. Oh. Wait for it. This is the moment. This is the day. Stampede. It goes in. They hook shot forward. Then they actually bring him down. 85 seconds. Bobica. Oh, he goes down towards the rune. He'll go down to resolution. Moon and Misery combining up. That's the easiest kill on the entire Invictus Gaming lineup. They're looking for Q. Whoops. But Horsestomp's going to miss. Now paralyzing cards can make game maybe not the easiest kill in the world. Clockwork Rocket will give him the vision. He still can't move forward. The Malediction is turning the Blink Dagger off all the bloody time. Slave won't be able to connect. The Golem's running in. Moon can't get close enough. Can he force up forward? Okay, Resolution can reach him. Now there's no Wish Doctor for a minute, but then again, this Chronosphere is really nice. Burning, focusing onto Resolution. They need to bring him down. The Whirling Axes will slow down XSS, but then again, he already got a lock. Maybe OP Cryptswarm goes out. Resolution will fall. Misery's Cox didn't create enough space. They still want to go for more with Exorcism up. Misery will fall. No time lock on the first hit. No time lock onto the leaner either. With a blink forward into the punch.
No buyback on Rezo. They did have to. They did expect Exorcism and an OP buyback, but very nice chrono from XXS, catching him right on the edge of it.
And this time it's not an Arcane Rune either. Roshan is still not up yet. We're not at his potential spawn time. But OD, sending the Warlock out into no man's land. He came here to Midas, one measly Satyr. This is the money situation of the Warlock.
Efficiency, bro.
He's 317 gold away from buyback. If he can get some level of gold from the next fight, then at least he can have something to bring in upheaval, to bring in Shadow World time, or even Fatal Bonds works beautifully when Weehawk can just pound away at somebody.
The upheaval like this, the defensive upheaval on that high ground, is actually making it very hard for IG to really siege properly.
Well, this might help him. They're giving space for Bobica on the bottom lane. So obviously Roshan, they're still waiting for him to spawn up. They'll have to wait almost 2 minutes for him to get all the way up. Nightstalker is 1,000 gold away from an Aghanim Scepter, an item we've rarely seen on a Nightstalker just because you got enough from Hunter in the Night, but Bobica still wants to get it in this game.
Yeah, it still can be quite nice. Just be able to get vision of where the Warlock is. The initiations are so crucial in this game. So unable to really get anything out of that kill onto the Troll Warlord, and they had to expend, like we said, the buyback on the Death Prophet. Troll now hitting level 25. So he can choose that 20% magic resist talent if he wants to, since the Whirling Axes doesn't seem like it's too big. Okay, so he does go for the Whirling Axes though, anyway.
Misery's a sacrificial lamb. Burning has an Invisor, and he's watching Roshan. Still 1 minute. Barbica needs another 500 gold. He's getting there.
He's close.
Bit by bit. I'm still not certain about him buying out for it, but if he can have that unobstructed nighttime vision, then hey, why not?
Void buys out completely. Buys a full refresher.
Wait, what?
Yep.
Refresher when you already have a 60-second Aghanim Scepter?
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't make as much sense, because then he would have just never gone the Ags in the first place.
He doesn't even have the mana for it. He needs a mango. Good, he goes and buys it. Cool.
And then TP's out. Does he get underneath the Observer Ward? No. Because it's actually darkness, where they didn't see the refresher orb. Mm-hmm. The Observer Ward was too restricted. Burning. Roshan's still not up yet.
OP gives him the bottle. He's got a DD rune in his bottle for the Weaver, so their damage issues will be solved a little bit from that. Mm-hmm. And he picked up a full BKB now, so he's got his own kind of survivability tool, and it's full duration late game, so that's quite nice. And he's level 25 too, so 2200 Shukuchi movement speed.
Well, here's nighttime. Your nighttime.
They've got the new gem.
He's so far with this. Resolution. Rod of Atos right on top of him. The Chronosphere. It only catches the Troll Waller, but maybe that will be enough. Rock wall fall. Where's the extra help? Hookshot comes forward from Misery. Q got the Malediction off, but Burning. Will he actually have enough? Under the cover of his BKB, Resolution's almost gone. He will finally fall down. Faceless Boy was the other one who sacrificed his own life for this. OP needs the distance. He's too low, but Spirit Siphon is helping him out. Burning, he is beyond godlike. The Weaver can just do the work. Troll Warlord, after his buyback, has just put enough pause in for IG to back out.
Yeah, Exorcism's starting to run a little bit low. The Void died before getting his second Chronosphere off, and this fight was a lot due to the DD rune that Burning actually had saved inside that bottle. His damage was able to bring down the Troll Warlord fast enough.
The 40 minute plus, it's bottle gaming.
Yep.
Burning already used his swarm, so they can't get a clear look inside the pit until Boboka moves a little bit closer.
Thanks to
upheaval, this is making it very, very difficult. They have to run down through the pit. Misery, hook shots off cooldown in a second, but now he's got the bugs on him. Boboka silences up Warlock, so they get the movement forward. Resolution, still killing off Roshan. OP has a spirit siphon, and Boboka just sits up on top of the hillside. Keep those silences going. Resolution's in actually a lot of trouble. Has to BKB to stay alive. Burning now disengages. Shukuchi up, back down again. Weeha has triggered his own BKB, gets a light strike around the Death Prophet. They just keep pushing her forward. They want to keep fighting on her. But who do you go on? It's Weeha. The Rod of Atos roots her to the ground, and she will deny herself at the last moment with the Bloodstone. But this will now allow Invictus Gaming to take Roshan.
Void responds too. That was without Chronosphere that fight. That was both without Chrono and without Death Prophet. But these 5 second BKBs are just showing what happens when they get to late game. And look what's right outside of the pit. Arcane Rune. The double runes.
He doesn't bottle it this time, but it won't matter. Exorcism is already back off cooldown. They're coming. They're going to barrel down the mid lane to the already injured Tal. Force the buyback on the Lina. There's no buyback patrol or for Clockwork if they die. They're both on timers on this, so IG be very well aware of what's going on.
The upheaval again.
They really need to find a way to stop that.
XSS might just fall.
Bobica's looking for it. Oh, the silence.
He gets the silence. Nice. That extra cast range.
Oh, boy.
That bonus cast range, man.
Fortification. Slows it down.
He's level 25 on Death Prophet, too, so plus 8 exorcism spirits, so this Rax gets brought down very quickly. XXS awaiting for the jump opportunity.
They're not going to fight.
But they're out, yeah.
Yep. There's no point. You really don't want to lose that money on the Lina. You don't want to force a fight when your buybacks are still on cooldown.
Yep.
And you know IG are going to disengage after the melee of Rax is taken.
Yep. And you know they're going to get another Arcane Rune in about 2 minutes anyway.
Oh, wait. Hang on, no. It's one minute, sorry. It's a regeneration. Are they really going to come out to fight their shrine? Burning takes it and then scutters himself away.
More survivability now for OP. He's got a full Shiva's Guard. It's going to help a lot versus the Chora Warlord, not just for the armor that it gives, but also for the damage, attack speed reduction, and the slow. Because these BKBs are just, they're at 5 seconds now.
You've got Shiva's, you've got Skadi, so many slows. Even with the immunity, there's still a lot that control you, or can control you. But they need to keep this push going. Look to get into the tier 3 tower if possible, because they still, okay, they've taken out the mid, that's fantastic, but this lineup that comes from Odd is still enough that they can man fight against IG if they can just dodge big things like the Chronosphere.
They just get kited so hard. Now they have Aetherlens as well on the Nightstalker. He actually has like so much that he can do to just prevent this Troll Warlord. He can Atos him from a mile away. They have Yule Scepters, they have everything aplenty. Two Solar Crests, etc.
How do you keep Nightstalker powerful during daytime? Get a haste rune. And then potentially trigger darkness. Moon, he's got himself a Tinker Ward down, instantly realizes he is not alone and TB's away to safety.
It's not just the haste rune. Did you click on the Weaver?
No, not a double damage.
He's got a double damage in his bottle. He's ready to go.
Stupid.
Double runes, maybe. I haven't seen this happen though, like this kind of like situation where it's like Arcane DD.
It feels like rune abuse. More than anything else, it's rune abuse.
Like, look at this. Look at the runes being picked up right now.
31 activated. Alright. Even the Nightstalker is like second on this list. But the ones which are taken, like even though there's 14 here, it was those three arcanes for OP.
Yep.
That just made this even more brutal than it already was. So double damage rune, you know Burning will trigger that, then just push. I don't know if he even switches the Dragonlance up by the time it turns on.
He'll try to.
Well, defensive cogs, OP wants to walk around it. Free wave will get through. There is no fortification this time from Odd, so they are forced to fight. There is no other choice here. They have to go into the engagement. Clockwork's being kept down. He's got a hookshot available. Fatal Bonds will connect Burning as well as OP together. Laguna Blade, the hookshot out. Burning is low, but he's not going to timelift until now. Now he's got more time to scurry himself away.
The Chronosphere is perfect.
They caught Troll Warlord, and there's your second one. It locks Warlock in position. Cancel any upheaval and stop the game. There's lag for a moment. You've lost the Clockwork. Centaur Warrunner is currently being siphoned like a fuel tank by Death Prophet. And we'll go again. Troll Warlord's not in a great position. The Death Ward's doing work from the back lines. He gets time locked as well instead of his own BKB. And there's your slow. There's your control. Warlock can't go anywhere. And this could be it. You're buying back. It's desperation time from Odd. IG got what they wanted again. It's another melee racks down. They don't actually have to back out if they don't want to. But you don't have any of the big abilities up either. So there's also no big reason to stay. Daytime reaches. I think it may just be that time to back out until you can get a good initiation and your abilities back up again.
Yeah, like you mentioned, the glyph was on cooldown, so they tried to take the fight in some way, otherwise they just lose the racks for free. Death Prophet Ultimate with the plus 8 Exorcism Spirits is just way too much damage on the buildings. And it's going to be back up in 35 seconds as well.
They're four men fatally bonded up, and they still don't care. I suppose when both the initiators from Odd are gone, burning! okay, he wants to die anyway.
Yeah, it's okay.
It's an Aegis, the Immortal. Yep.
They've got the Aegis and the Chief, so they've got the... They've got all the windows here to take the racks.
Look at Bobica. He's just trying to reach the wall lock. A little bit too deep to go through that upheaval. The Rod of Atos will only connect onto Weeha. They just can't get in close enough. Now the Chronosphere catching Lina and Warlock. They want resolution. His BKB's protecting him, beating into the Death Prophet. They still need more friends. Clockwork is back in a couple of seconds. Bobica gets nuked on down. A double Light Strike array. Weeha, the cannon, is released. A double kill for resolution. In fact, it's the Troll Warlock that gets it. A quick stampede. They need to get closer, but OP and Burning, they're too fast away, and there's trouble at home. The top and the mid have pushed in heavily, but Otter holding on by a hair.
It's just these double chronos, it's too much having it up online every single time. Like, Resolution just gets kited so hard. He actually can barely do any damage in these instances now. It's Lina finishing up the MKB, trying to dish out as much damage as she can, but she's not really doing too much. They have so much armor, so much different resilience from the side of IG. They're just looking really solid right now, and just... They're so mobile. Like, this 533 movement speed Death Prophet, 750 movement speed Shukuchi and Weaver, Night Stalker with pretty much perma haste because it's nighttime during all of these engagements. It's too much for them to really get the proper lockdown, and they're just too tanky. There's no big damage coming out from Odd, even when they get like a four-man fatal bond, as you mentioned.
Odd need to find a kill right now, and they know it.
Nice desperation.
Yeah, it really is. They know. They know this game is over if they can't get a huge fight. And so far, nothing has been on the terms, but you're doing this without Chaotic Offering. 28 seconds. It's on cooldown. They need to burst somebody, and maybe the Faceless Void will be it. They bring him down, but 85 seconds, he's down, but not when you've got the money. The buyback is there, and Resolution's on the run. OP and Burning, focusing this Troll Warlord. Misery will come out to help. The Cogs, the Chrono is there. Troll Warlord will fall. The Exorcism will rip them apart, and that should really be the game with Clockwork falling. He won't have buyback. How many will they lose? The Lina is, well, it's likely. The Troll has buyback available. The Lina does not. Issues galore facing Odd.
This should be it. This should be where IG's able to close it out. Great buyback coming out from them. You could feel the desperation from Odd, but they were put in a position where they just kind of have to do that. There's nothing else that they can really do versus this massive power from IG with the Exorcism.
Yeah. They're actually back so quickly that Bobica can recover his gem. Oh, wait. No, he bought an extra one. He can carry two.
That's Miseries, but...
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought there was one Bobica dropped before. They never regained it.
There's been gems aplenty all over the place. But yeah, they claim the Mega Creeps finally.
And Bobica will have a look inside. What's he going to get? A quick Blink Dagger so he can jump away from the Troll Warlord. Megas are up for Invictus Gaming. Exorcism has got another 38 seconds, so there's one last fight to be had in 20 seconds time. That's if... And actually, IG are being very, very apprehensive about this push. So they will have the fight in 13 seconds when Lina will respawn. Upheaval, just to slow down any kind of attack and approach towards the tier 4 towers.
Double Chrono's back. They've got Exorcism up in 15 seconds. They're probably going to go check out the runes, see if Rosh is up.
Roshan is near max spawn time. So they'll have to wait. There goes the Radiant scan. They realize they backed up for a moment.
Look at the damage, though. I think this tells a story in itself. You see Troll Warlord? Resolution is actually just getting controlled completely in this game. Like, the Chronospheres, just everything coming out from them is... It's just too much for him to handle.
Yeah.
Too much control for a poor Troll.
We're about to see that control once again. Invictus Gaming. They're grouping up.
Last fight.
Yep. Here goes your darkness. It's all or nothing now. The Rod of Atos gonna be Lotus Orb back towards Bobica, but Misery! Oh, they can Blade Mail up. This gives Weaver just a second thought about attacking into him. Weaver attacks the tier 4 talents. Remember, that's what they're here for. Kill off the Radiant Ancient. Now give you a victory. The Chronosphere, more of a controller. They go around it thanks to the Stampede. Death Prophet, can they bring her down? Not when the secondary Chrono is actually triggered. Burning, ripping apart. Actually, Weaver has enough damage. Death Prophet will die, but you've lost Troll Warlord with no buyback. You'll have your buyback coming in from the Death Prophet, plus the BTs. Everyone's coming back to life, if it's possible. Fatal Bonds, Q, as well as Burning, connected together. If Burning keeps taking damage, okay, it's actually worn off now. Q will be fine. The Paralyzing Cast giving the control, not to mention the Creep Wave is doing the job for Invictus Gaming. GG, well played. Invictus Gaming will take out the series 2-1, eliminating Odd. They destroyed an entire planet in Epicenter.
Damn. That was a very kind of back and forth series, or back and forth game, but in the end, IG did have a bit of a better hold